in the past, so I want to see how we look against Indiana.
What does a shutout mean to you? Obviously, it's the first letter of your name, but what does a zero mean to you?
I think it's just the testimony of us following through with what we had set out, what we had planned this whole week. I know last game we had a strong first half. Came out the second half, they were able to score, they put some points on the board. Yeah. But this game, it was a full four-quarter game. And I was before the game, I know like they kind of got into shouting competition with us. So just to be able to prove that Ohio State is not to be messed with, I think that was pretty big.
Were you surprised by that shouting competition?
No, I mean, they're a team that prides themselves on toughness. And I know when you have two powerhouses in Ohio going at it, guys are going to – it's a lot of pride at stake. So, that's the route they chose to take. I think we chose to just respond with our play on the field.
How much do you guys in your cornerback room talk about tackling and hitting hard and playing physical?
I don't think that we have to talk about that necessarily because Coach Halfley, I mean, that's just – you're not going to get on the field if you're not willing to tackle. And, I mean, that's kind of what he stressed. I mean, he's been in the NFL, so he knows what teams are looking for. They want corners that are willing to tackle, safeties that can come down and make that open field tackle. So when you have 11 guys flying to the ball and four guys in the back end that are all willing to tackle, I think it makes it for a nice defense.
But come on, man. There are some great cover corners out there who don't want to hit. You know that. There are some guys who get that reputation sometimes. Aren't there some corners?
Yeah, they won't play at Ohio State. They won't play at Ohio State.
Did you know, like, when did that click in with you? Did you know that as a young guy here? Did Coach Halfley even reinforce that more now? Because clearly you do hit. Sean does hit. Damon does hit.
I would say that started with Coach Combs. He's one of those guys that if you're playing soft, he's going to come, he's going to get in your face, and he's going to tell you that you're playing soft and that you won't touch the field. So, starting with Coach Combs, I think Coach Halfley was just able to kind of cultivate that culture and carry it on from what Coach Combs built.
And then, so Sean pops two guys today, turns into a tough interception and almost a chase interception. Is that all right with you if the corners are making the hits, but the linebackers, defensive ends are getting the picks?
It's okay for the shutout, but hopefully down the road it can be vice versa. But as long as someone's getting hit and someone's getting interception, I think that it makes the Bulls look good regardless.
Does this – what's happening with the defense for the first 2 weeks? You're being very clear that you're not getting ahead of yourself. You know Indiana's going to be a test. But is this what you thought it would be when you practiced in the preseason?
I think we had a whole winter, a whole spring to kind of just deal with kind of letting down the silver bullets. We heard a lot of stuff from foreign players letting us know that they still had faith in us, even though that we didn't have a good year. And just to have to hear that from foreign players is kind of embarrassing. So I think that everyone took it to heart and just wanted to come out and be able to make kind of a statement that, I mean, we're not going to be the group that kind of let the silver bullet slip away.
So you came in with Chase. What do you think of the way he's playing right now?
Chase is playing lights out. I know that I can tell that he's really comfortable in his skill set and his shows. I mean, he's playing really fast.
You guys make him better, or does he make you guys better in the back?
I think this year is kind of going hand in hand. I mean, as far as he's getting pressure on the quarterbacks, and I mean, actually, as far as secondary, I mean, you're not going to have, I mean, that D line, having a great D line helps. So that starts off the play. So I would say Chase is making us better.
Jeff, the physicality you guys are playing with, was that an emphasis coming into this year, or was that just a byproduct of you guys, you know, playing fast and being confident in the scheme?
Playing fast and being confident in the scheme. I mean, we know what you're doing, and you're just able to play so much faster. So when guys are also at one, I mean, our guys' demeanors is we're willing to tackle. So when you have guys that can do that, I think it just makes your defense so much better. 11 willing tacklers as opposed to having maybe 7 or 8.
And that seemed to show up almost immediately last week. And Coach Halfley talked about wanting you guys to be confident all summer. But how is it that you sort of showed up confident in a scheme that was brand new to you guys and you had to play the game?
I think we didn't necessarily have a choice. I mean, our backs were against the wall, I guess, from following the Rose Bowl. So, I mean, when your back's against the wall, that's kind of when you get the best out of someone because they're gonna give you all they have. They're gonna fight to the end. So what we've been doing is just going out there to practice every single day and just working really hard.
Can you explain the difference that you mentioned earlier, the front, the pressure they provide? Just explain the incredible luxury that is on the back end, what that gives you as a defense overall, but especially from where you're coming from, where you're playing.
It's a great luxury to have a defensive line that's really great, not just with the ones, but as far as the twos and threes. I mean, there's a lot of depth in that room. I mean, sometimes you get a little salty because a ball might be coming to you, and then right before it's thrown, it's a sack. But, I mean, at the end of the day, it's like, if we're getting sacks and TFLs, we look great. So I'm all for the Bulls looking great.
I think we all get that the shutout's a big deal.
Shutout's a big deal.
But explain that. What does it do for you from an from ego, from a confidence standpoint as you move forward?
I think it puts on film what we're capable of. That's the biggest thing it does for guys are going to cut on the film, like Indiana will cut on the film, and they'll see that we pitched a shutout. And it just does a great thing for the morale of a defense, knowing that you know you have the ability to pitch a shutout. I don't remember the last shutout at Ohio State, but to have one against an 11-2 team, yeah, I mean, that speaks a lot for what the defense has came from last year.
What does it say about stripping the ball on the fumble there at the very end? Is that just you guys go to the whistle and beyond it, or, I mean, what is that?
We preach that, create turnovers. I mean, the first guy in, I mean, you guys probably heard this a bunch of times, but first guy hits, second guy strips. So when you have a running back trying to get loose with his ball security, you have to be able to take a chance and get that out. So I think the defense taking a lot of pride in maintaining that shutout, even when the twos and threes came in. I think it's really big that we were able to do that.
Jeff, what's your favorite aspect about this defense?
I think that it allows guys to mix up a lot of looks, so you don't necessarily know what we're doing. It allows guys to play really fast, and I would say that a lot of allows guys to play comfortably.
Have you talked to